Start by lifting the vehicle and setting it on jack stands. Remove the rear wheel. Remove these two bolts. I'm holding them on one side with a ratchet and removing them with an impact wrench. Remove your rear seat. Just pull up on the corner like you see here. Remove this bolt. Fold down the rear seat and pull the bolster off. Remove the top mounting nuts. Remove your sway bar link. I'm holding the nut with a wrench and twisting the center stud with an Allen key. Because of the way the new shocks are designed, I have to remove the brake lines. It's very important that you loosen the flare nut before removing any clips. Once you've completely loosened the brake line flare nut, you can remove this clip holding the soft line and the hard line onto the rear strut. With all your fasteners removed, you can pull the old strut out. I had a helper pushing down on the suspension to give me more space while I weave the old struts out and the new struts in. When installing the new strut, you can install the top nuts first if you're having trouble getting everything to line up. Here you see me tightening the top mounting nuts. Next, reconnect your brake lines and install the retaining clip. Reinstall your sway bar link. If you have the extra money, now is a perfect time to replace your sway bar links. They are typically not very expensive. The last thing that I'm tightening up are these main mounting bolts on the bottom. Go ahead and reinstall your wheel and let the car down.